So we could do a little news. We've got Gilbert Gottfried waiting out there to do the news with us.
Oh, Gilbert's here?
Gilbert's stopping by.
I saw him on Conan O'Brien last night.
Yeah. Gilbert, you want to come in? Gilbert, very nervous. He's actually being bar mitzvahed next weekend.
Also, I learned that Gilbert was one of the last people to leave my book party.
Yeah, Gilbert was one of the last people. He was the second to last person to leave your book party. You were the last person.
There was still food.
Gilbert was unbelievable. You know when you finish your shrimp and the guy comes around on a tray with a shrimp?
Yeah.
And they have like a little bowl on the tray that you can put the tails in?
Uh-huh.
Gilbert was eating the tails.
Oh, yeah. He was sucking.
I was picking the tails out of there.
Yeah, after people ate the shrimp.
Did you enjoy yourself, Gilbert?
Oh, yes.
Staying till the very end.
Oh, yes.
Gilbert and Belzer were bonding the whole night. Gilbert and Belzer, like, you know, they're too good to talk to anyone else.
Well, they're in a special fraternity called Comedians.
And you walk up to Gilbert at the party, and Gilbert's kind of like Fred in this way. Even though I've met Gilbert a million times, had him on my show a million times, I've been to the hospital to visit him. You walk in, and Gilbert's like, oh, hi. You know, like, he doesn't...
He acts as if he can't remember who you are.
He doesn't recognize you.
Well, scariest moment is we had nothing to say to each other.
We really did. Yeah. I mean, it was the first time I think I've been in a social situation with you, and Gilbert and I have nothing in common. We don't want... Because, like, you say something to Gilbert to get conversation going, you go up to Gilbert, and you go, hey, man, how's it going? And then right away, he's like, oh, man.
That's it.
Yeah, right. You know, and then you go, and then I go, So, Gilbert, what are you up to? He goes...
We like gave a big smile, a handshake, and then stood there comfortably. And
two social nothing.
Yes.
Two guys who are inept at small talk.
But at least Gilbert wants to stay. I mean, you're not good at partying, and you go home.
Yeah, I don't know what... I think Gilbert thinks he's going to get laid. There were a lot of good-looking girls at the party, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Did you get to talk to any?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
I nailed a few of them.
Is that why you were there later? You just had nowhere to go?
I had nowhere to go.
Oh, man. Because Belzer, what time did Belzer leave?
I think Belzer left 5 minutes after the party started.
Really? Did he, like... So who did you hang out with?
He was there for a while.
So who were you hanging out with besides Belzer?
Well, the pecking order got worse and worse.
Yeah, I know. Like, you were in the corner for a while. Like, Gilbert had to be in the special area, celebrity area.
Right.
You know.
Yeah.
And he was immediately ushered into the celebrity area. He had to let everyone know where he was.
Maybe that's why Sadie was being treated better than he usually is.
Yeah, and then him and Belzer were in the corner doing dreidel routines.
Yeah, they were doing routines for each other.
And then my dad went over and he goes, who's those comedians again? I go, that's Gilbert Gottfried and Belzer. Yeah, those are two funny guys. I'm going to go over there. So he goes over, because my father's another social nothing. My father has no ability to talk to people. And then he hung out with Gilbert and Belzer while they did their dreidel routine. And then he told me he held his own with them.
Right.
I went over to them. I held my own with those two.
In other words, he stood there.
Yeah, he stood there. He claims he contributed to your bit.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It would have been nowhere without him.
It was a funny bit, too. Gilbert was a dreidel salesman who was in trouble because all the dreidels with gimbals on them, all the gimbals were broken.
Let me ask you something.
Got to be there.
How did something like that start?
I don't know. Belzer and I don't. I guess Gilbert and Belzer used to be like Martin and Lewis. They had a routine together. I don't know what it was. But they're standing around at a party, and those two finally find each other. Uh-huh. And Belzer's pretty inept socially, because I never have anything to talk to Belzer about.
It's so hard to talk to those guys when we're not on the air.
I was once out with Belzer sort of socially. We were in a car. I had done a Letterman or something, and he somehow ended up in my car. And I don't know how he ended up in there. He wasn't on the show.
He wasn't on the show.
And we were there, and he goes, hey, can you give me a ride to some bar?
Yeah.
And we were in there. And we were in the car for like 5 minutes, and we have nothing to say. So Belzer just got out, and I don't know where he went.
Well, I noticed that when I came to greet these guys at the party, it's like, after you said, hi, thanks for coming.
Yeah, there's nothing.
There's nowhere to go.
I don't understand. After Belzer, because all I saw you with was Belzer.
And then he's so politically correct.
Yeah, oh.
You don't even know what to say.
You can't say anything.
Any joke you make, he goes, yeah, that's fine, yeah.
Yeah. He is the comedy god.
Yeah. So making fun of starving people. Sure. Yeah, right. Country that does business with racist countries. Yeah, sure.
Right. You're eating shrimp and Russia's on the brink of disaster.
Yeah, Mexicans are eating.
Right. I don't know, but it was like my dad, Gilbert, and Belzer. And thank God, because my dad was just staring at the wall. My father was just like staring at the wall. Thank God, you know when you came in, they had it on TV. Then my father just stood in front of the TV.
Oh, so he watched the party.
Yeah, just playing him in front of people. Then I just see him standing there, and I go, "Hey, Dad, there's Gilbert and Belzer."
To get rid of him.
Yeah.
like here's a funny toy to play with.
Yeah. So what did my dad actually contribute to your comedy bit?
Absolutely nothing.
He claims that he got involved and said that the dreidel salesman should have like a dial-a-mattress franchise, and it sounded like an awfully thin premise
to make anything out of it. It really was. It was one of those where
1-800-DIAL-A-DREIDEL.
Yeah, I don't know, something like that.
Like, well, you don't tell him to leave, but
yeah, right.
Yeah,
exactly. You were humoring his father.
Yes. He would say, "Hey, can you leave?"
Yes.
That would have been funny.
Yeah.
Hey, Dad, you want to split?
Excuse me, you're ruining the whole bit.
Understand pig Latin? Amscray.
Yeah.
Well, I was glad that you were busy with my dad.
Oh yeah.
He thought you were really funny.
Oh, yeah?
For what it's worth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he contributed a lot.
Yeah. He claims he held his own. So after Belzer left, who did you hang out with at the party?
Oh, it just got thinner and thinner. After a while, it was like Belzer's agent.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Belzer's publicist.
Belzer's brother.
Yeah. People who met Belzer. You know.
People who had spoken to him at the party.
Who were you back there with? Phoebe Snow?
Yeah, at one point. Let's see who was there.
Kreskin, did he get
Kreskin? Kreskin. Yeah, I was there when Kreskin said hello to Richard's brother. Hi, Richard.
Did Kreskin come over to you? Did he know who you were?
Yeah, he does that, like, very annoying back slapping.
Yeah, and then he starts shaking your hand real hard?
Yeah, shakes your hand really and really hits you in the back, and it's like...
What a group of celebrities. Gilbert Gottfried and Kreskin and Phoebe Snow.
The A-list. Like people Mike Douglas wouldn't want.
Yeah, right. Yeah, like that. Tonight on Mike Douglas, Richard Belzer, Gilbert Gottfried, Phoebe Snow, and Kreskin. What a show.
Oh, and May Pang.
Yeah, May Pang.
Yes.
She slept with John Lennon.
Yes. I once saw an 8x10 of hers where it actually said the girl who slept with John Lennon.
Did it really?
Didn't even give
I believe
name.
That.
Yes.
It doesn't even say May Pang.
No.
Here it is, the girl who slept with John Lennon. She's still living off that whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
It's sad. Like, she's got a husband and kids and stuff, but, you know, she's famous for her vagina.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Or where her vagina's been.
Right. And who's been with. It's kind of weird, too, because you're talking to her, and she's in the celebrity area.
Yes.
And you're like, well, you know, hey, can somebody come here and check the celebrity area? Let's make sure that this is really a celebrity area.
Yeah, sex with a celebrity one.
Yeah, I mean, does that constitute...
Does everybody get in?
Yeah. I mean, her husband's more of a celebrity. Because her husband's some kind of record producer. He produced a Bowie album.
So he must be real proud of her.
Yeah. But, like, I think that in the back of his mind, it's always like, oh, man, you know, am I as good as John Lennon? She's still talking about John Lennon for 20 years. I said to her, man, at these parties, you should stand on your hands, because that's what people really want to look at. That's where John Lennon, we want to be closer to John Lennon. But she got insulted.
Yeah. He drives to the show so she could say she spread her legs for John Lennon.
There you go.
Yeah. Yeah,
right, good.
Yeah,
make sure.
Meanwhile, we're like making fun of a dead celebrity, you know. And she's like a Japanese woman. Like,
Japanese American.
A lot of trouble.
And, right, and like it's been easy for Japanese people.
Yeah,
right,
sure. Right, like the whole Hiroshima.
Like maybe she could have been John Lennon if people weren't so damn biased against Japanese.
Yeah,
right.
Sure, like we're ignoring her intelligence and everything she's done.
I think she's Chinese Belzer.
Oh, so now you're calling her Japanese when she's like Chinese.
Like you can't tell the difference.
Yeah, like you're throwing them one.
Like Tiananmen Square was for no reason whatsoever.
Yeah.
Chinese brave Chinese students.
Standby doesn't help at all.
Good deal. You went to one moratorium.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Gilbert has a plug.
And big ones.
And how'd you get that job on Conan O'Brien?
Yeah, nice job. Gilbert did a walk-on. Things are going well for you, huh, buddy?
I know the right people.
When do you spend so much time at the VIP area, Robin? All right, this Saturday at 8 p.m. on NBC... Gilbert has worked this whole Problem Child franchise into like
soaking it for every time.
You really are. Problem Child was this movie that came out with John Ritter that was awful.
It was a couple of years ago, too.
Even Gilbert admits it was awful. It was horrible. And then someone did a Problem Child 2.
I don't know how they got 2.
And Gilbert was in that. And now there's Problem Child 3, which is just made for TV. But Gilbert, none of the original cast is in it.
Ritter's
gone. Yeah,
Gordon is there.
Yeah, so who's the John Ritter role?
William Catt.
Who's that?
The guy who was in The Great American Hero.
Oh, him?
Yes.
I see. So he has the problem child, and you play a principal, right?
Yeah, well, they
he always was.
They don't even keep the job straight.
What are you this
time? In the first one, I was an adoption agency worker.
Oh, that's
second
right.
one, the principal.
Yeah.
Now I'm a dentist.
Really?
Yeah. Is the kid the same, at least?
No, like the kid must be about 45.
And when they direct this thing, like, does anybody even care what you do?
No.
Like,
no.
Is it one take and you're done? It's like an Ed Wood movie?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
They did it in one afternoon.
Chairs are falling over. Nobody cares.
Yeah, I mean, like, does anyone pay any attention to detail? Like, Gilbert, your watch was on the other wrist in the last scene.
It's like an Ed Wood movie.
Yeah.
Like,
if the camera was on, it's a great thing.
Yeah, right.
There were people, you know, pedestrians were walking through the scene. It's okay. It's perfect.
Do they have, like, do you have to do, like, second takes and third takes?
Not too many.
Really?
They still have you do a second, like the first one wasn't good enough.
Right. Like it made a difference. What is it?
Do you want to talk to May Pang or has the moment passed?
No, that's fine.
Oh, okay.
What is she going to do? Defend herself? May.
Yes.
Hi, May.
Hi. Oh,
it's
come
wonderful
on. Come on.
Oh, come on, what?
Not talk about John.
Wait, John Lennon's here. Hold it a second.
It's wonderful talking to you again, May.
Oh, I'm being channeled now? Is this channeling time?
Wait, yeah.
Would you take off your panties for me, May?
Oh, God.
Hey, it's
well,
like
I thought you know how to rip them off. Never mind.
John's back and he's horny.
Oh, yeah.
And Yoko's unavailable.
I've been away a long time, May. Come in and have sex with me.
How weird is it? John Lennon goes home and... Yoko says, hey, I don't know what's your problem. Get out of my house and go off with May.
Here, take her.
She's the greatest wife in the world.
Right.
Yeah.
Isn't she great?
Yeah, fixes you up with another girl.
Doesn't my wife say I'm depressed? May's real cute, too. I mean, much cuter than Yoko any day of the week.
Sam's a very secure woman. She gave John a prettier woman than she was.
May is really cute. I can't believe that, like...
Oh, well, thank you, Howard, for once you gave me a compliment.
And lovely breasts.
Yeah, lovely.
Lovely.
Hey, you know what? Talk to her like John Lennon will drive her nuts because that's what she...
Don't.
Oh, I want you. I want you.
Talk about that.
Please let me touch your buttocks.
Oh.
I want to touch your firm, young buttocks.
I never understand this either with May. It's like, she seems like a real intelligent woman and stuff when I'm talking to her. And then I realized, just because he was John Lennon, she went off with him.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't.
True.
I worked for him.
What?
I worked for him.
I know, but I mean,
but
like...
that wasn't the reason.
You were in love with him?
After all, he chased after me. I tried to stop it.
I just feel bad for your husband. What do you mean he chased after you?
Oh, he chased after me. I had no idea.
Oh, and you didn't want... You had no idea what? That he was John Lennon?
That he was with the Beatles.
I told him I didn't want to go out with him.
I don't know who you are, Beatles leader.
Yeah.
Oh, no,
not saying she didn't know who he was. She said she tried not to have an affair with him.
Oh, yeah. While your legs were spread.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Howard.
Oh, come on. Be honest.
You tried to beat him off with your legs.
Yeah. Your naked legs.
My naked legs.
So how long did you resist?
Did you smack him in the head with your breast?
It was a little bit. It was a couple of weeks.
Yeah. You waited a few weeks.
I didn't want to know about it.
Well, it's been a week and 3 days. Let's have sex.
But what's weird is that, like, and then Yoko came to you and said, "Okay, have sex with my husband."
She said that, and I told her she was out of her mind. I said, "I'm not doing this." And she goes, "Oh, yes, you will." And I said, "You're out of it."
And then she wasn't out of it.
No, she wasn't out of it.
I had no idea. I thought she was talking out of the side of her mouth somewhere else. Or
that's just the way she talks.
Right. Out of the side of her mouth. What, are you making Japanese jokes?
Hey, ma'am, sorry, ma'am. Sure. Hey, like, wasn't right.
Here is a woman that keeps claiming that she didn't know anything about the Beatles that lived. She lived in the heart of London in 1964.
Yeah. Sure. She was the one who went up to John Lennon and said, "John Lennon, I don't know who you are, Beatles leader."
All you need is rub.
So you say you resisted.
Yes.
Yet 30 years later, you're listening to his outtakes on his cassettes.
I have not touched any of those things in a long time.
It really is weird, because one time May was up here, and she took the cassettes. She had some cassettes that John Lennon had recorded. She's up there in the jock lounge playing them for everyone who walks by.
Oh, boy.
I was like, "May, you're married now.
Yeah.
That was about
get over it."
Years ago.
Yes, really?
Where?
Yes.
Not, when did you do that? I didn't hear that.
Oh, no, you were gone, I think.
You mean at the party?
At the
party. You a gook? He called you a gook at the party?
He told me a gook. He goes, "You gooks." And then he goes, you nips." And I said, "Why don't you get it right and call me a chink then?"
So then I called her a chink.
Wait a second. Hold it a second. Wait, let me get this straight.
You know what? I didn't know Gilbert was having such a good time at the
party. No wonder everyone flocks to Gilbert.
This is off the air you're doing this? Yes.
Oh, okay. Man. Well, no one could accuse Gilbert of being a phony. You know what it is? Gilbert, what time, can I ask you a question? At what point in the party was this? Was this toward the end?
This is towards the end.
Okay, you want to know what happens to him?
Does he drink?
No, he doesn't drink. He goes there, and he thinks because he's, like, you know, in movies and stuff, he's going to get laid.
Yeah.
He gets there, it gets to the end, because I've heard about him. He was at one party, and there was, like, a Playboy Playmate there.
It was a Playboy party.
He couldn't get laid. He felt he should. He went up to the Playboy Playmate. He started pulling the girl's bra straps and, like, pulling, you know, the back of her bra like a little kid does. And he kept doing it so much that she called over a bouncer. The bouncer picked Gilbert up and threw him in a closet and locked the door. And kept Gilbert locked in a closet for the entire party.
Because
then when he opened the closet,
so what happened
after her again.
Yeah, and then what happened, yeah, I heard that. And then Gilbert, what happens is he's at the party late. He thinks he should have gotten laid or picked up a girl. Then May comes over just to say hello. And he starts screaming. He starts, yeah, he says, you gook. Because you probably couldn't find your bra strap.
And I started complimenting her on all the good Godzilla films.
So you just walked up and started calling her gook.
Well,
he's talking.
And he says, I'm trying to pay you a compliment. And I'm talking to somebody else. And I'm going, he's yelling at you, gook, you gook.
Gilbert.
Then she took out a radio she took out a camera to take a picture of me, so I complimented her on what great cameras those people make. I said,
That's
you people make great cameras.
Well, she must have been really charmed.
Yeah, she was.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Way to everybody else around us.
See, I want a tape of that.
Yes.
Way to circulate, Gilbert.
And Gilbert, how do you like when Gilbert got up to make a speech at Robin's party? Robin asked him to make a speech because, after all, Robin's new book is out, and it was very exciting. And Gilbert gets up, does one of his monologues from his act.
Yeah, I don't know what year that was.
Everyone's, like, in shock because Gilbert has said nothing about Robin and just starts doing his act. Even Belzer leaned up and goes, does this have anything to do with Robin?
But then, no.
Then
you got up and spoke about Robin, and no one listened in either case.
That's true.
Yeah.
You might as well do it right.
Don't waste those kind of words. So what did you really want to say, Gilbert?
Yes.
He doesn't want to say anything except gook and nips.
Yeah.
Gook and you called her a gook and a nip.
Yes.
Oh.
And you're proud
Until
of that.
Until she asked to be called a jink, and then I called her a jink.
So wait a second, May.
Yes.
So you're claiming that you didn't know John... Okay, so you...
No, I didn't.
You fended off John's advances.
Yes.
But suddenly, like 2 or 3 weeks later, you slept with him.
Well, he followed the woman. I tried to take him home, and he didn't want to go home. We were working.
Oh, that's clear.
I tried. And all of a sudden, he sent the limo.
He was working on me penis.
Oh, yes.
Can you work on me penis, May? It's not quite finished.
Oh, yes, it is. I thought it was.
So listen to this.
Yes.
May still hasn't gotten over John Lennon. She's married, she has kids, and she loves her husband, Tony Visconti, very much.
Yeah.
But...
You never get over that first love, is what they say.
Well, first love, nothing. Woman's about the career out of it.
Oh.
Why is she at your book party? She slept with John Lennon.
No, because he's my friend.
Yeah, well, how did she become your friend?
I know with Robin. We go out.
Oh, I happened to meet her on the show because she slept with John Lennon.
Yeah, well, that's how everything happens in May's life.
Since then, she's been coming on to Ringo.
You didn't have this show.
What is it?
I was at May's apartment once, a long time ago.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it's changed since then, but there's this one wall in the apartment.
A shrine.
And like, May's got some really cool stuff. Like, she has a gold record in her name. For like walls and bridges and
which
stuff.
Which is ridiculous.
But she also has pictures of her and John. And it was like the entire wall from top to bottom was nothing but John Lennon paraphernalia.
I bet your husband must have made you take that down at this point.
Well, let's put it this way. We have his goal records up on the wall.
Yeah.
And in my house, I have none of those up.
In fact, it was really weird because May kept insisting that I had to come over to her apartment for something important.
Yeah.
This was like 7 years ago, so I'm like, oh, you never know.
Maybe you get it on.
And I got up there and I got to listen to some John Lennon tapes.
Oh, man.
Wait a minute.
Did she want to do you? Did you think she wanted to do you?
I had hoped. But when I got up there, I realized it was to listen to
the tapes. What was she wearing?
Oh, Gary. You went to that, tuxedo lingerie party, too.
What was she wearing when you went up there?
Oh, she was just normal.
Oh, so like she wasn't coming on?
No.
She didn't come out in negligee.
It was completely in my imagination.
You should have said, number nine.
Are you getting turned on, May?
Yeah, you should put on a John Lennon mask.
No, you'll have to appear in front of me first.
Yeah, May needs one of those John Lennon impersonators. Hey, Gilbert can do that.
Oh, yes.
Joe, but you sleep with May, right?
Yes, number 9.
Are you kidding? You sleep with anybody.
And you pretend to be John Lennon, right?
You
don't
sleep with me. Oh, that feels good. Oh, yes. Put your legs up higher, would you? Oh, oh, that's good. Not yet, not yet. Oh, oh.
That sounds very close.
Did John make a lot of noise? No, I'm being serious. Let's find. I mean, he's long gone. I mean,
I know he's long gone.
He can't sue.
Yeah.
Yeah. He made noise.
Was he like would he be like we whisper dirty words and stuff?
Yes.
And we just oh
does
me,
it
give me a kloogie.
Give me your black kloogie.
Give me your oriental kloogie.
Like what would he say to you?
I'm gonna keep that private.
Oh great.
Have you told Tony?
Come on.
Have you told Tony? What do you make Tony say the same thing?
Oh,
no.
Oh, hold my gland.
He's fabulous.
I want to hold your
gland. I want to hold your gland.
I want to hold your gland.
Tell me I'm bigger than Paul.
I don't know anything about Paul.
What?
I don't know anything about Paul.
But John was big, right?
He was that.
Really? Because I remember seeing him on the cover of those two virgins and looked pretty big.
Yeah? Am I hurting you? Tell me I'm hurting you. Please tell me I'm hurting you. I'm a legend.
Tell me about your kloogie again.
Tell me about your big kloogie. I'd like your big Asian kloogie.
Oh, dear Gilbert.
I want some big Asian kloogie. Oh, give it to me now. Give me a big Asian kloogie. Oh, oh. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So how were you responsible for, I forget, how were you responsible for Walls and Bridges?
I worked on all these albums. I was a production assistant. I worked on them.
So you got a gold album because you were having sex during Walls and Bridges with John, right?
Well, I also worked on Mind Games, Rock and
Roll.
What
did you do on Mind Games?
I did the same thing. I worked, what? I got all the musicians, I hired them.
Well, you mean he told you who to get and you...
And what I would do is I made sure I got them there on time. A lot of these musicians don't like to show up anywhere.
Me, get the musicians coffee.
That's right. Get them
quickly,
coffee.
And give me some Asian kloogie.
Oh, you want some Asian kloogie now?
Get Mr. Hendricks some Asian kloogie.
He'd like it, you know. He'd be quite fond of some Asian kloogie. He doesn't get enough. He doesn't get nearly enough Asian kloogie. Oh, May, give me that Asian kloogie.
Now.
No. Oh, I want it now.
Oh, dear.
And tape this album to your wall.
Imagine how good May must have been in the sack, though. I mean, because he's John Lennon.
Oh, yeah.
And he can get any girl, and he's hanging out with May. My God, it tastes like rice.
Can I have some more kloogie to go?
Doesn't it go good with soy sauce, please?
But an hour later, I'm horny again.
Now we're going to get calls from Linda Ronstadt, who doesn't like this show.
As an Asian American.
Hey, did you do anything like special to John that you've never even done for Tony?
Oh, I'm not going to...
Or did you do all your tricks for Tony as well?
I don't discuss that.
I'd love to go to bed with May.
But do you think that Tony has questioned her about this?
I think that most guys don't like to know. But I think Tony digs her because she was with John.
If your wife had slept with John Lennon, you wouldn't want to know everything?
I don't know.
Come on, Howard.
Who's better in bed, Tony or John?
Actually, Tony's great.
Do you wish that John had gotten you pregnant secretly so that you could have one of the Lennon children?
No.
Oh,
In fact, I said that in my book. I didn't want to be pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
You ever scream out John's name?
When you were Tony?
No.
That would be great.
Oh, yeah, right.
You know what? Let me put a hidden camera in your bedroom.
Oh, okay.
And then you're with Tony, and he's just screaming out, John, John. Let's just see his face.
Oh, no.
Who's the kloogie?
Yes, I want your kloogie now. Give me that fine kloogie.
I don't think the
Italian... Give me your Asian kloogie.
May, did I ever tell you you had an ass like a Peking duck?
You've never asked your wife about her other sexual experiences.
I sort of dabbled in it, and it got just ridiculous because she was with way too much weird stuff.
Oh, gee.
And she was with real losers. You think Gilbert's a loser? You should get the guy she was with. I'd be happy to have had her stuff with it. She had, like, real losers. She was with one guy who never left his room.
Yeah.
I mean, he couldn't go to school. He couldn't leave his room.
That might have been me.
He was an agoraphobic.
Yes.
And, like, that was her boyfriend.
She had sex with him?
Yeah.
I thought he was, like, cool back then.
I don't know, but the guy was, like, a real loser. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, he was. I mean, I never met him, but she tells me about him.
And
then she was with, like, a youth group leader who I saw on a bus one day. And the guy looked like he had that disease out of Zaire. The Ebola virus.
The Ebola virus.
Ebola virus. I don't know. It just looked real, really gross. And I don't know, man. I don't want to know. Like, and like, I'm sure, like, in Tony's mind, he's, like, with May, and he's like, you know, gee, I wonder if I'm... Am I a new territory? Am I pleasing? Am I a new territory, or am I going over the same?
Has he ever done that?
You know what it is, Howard?
Yeah.
You ask questions, you know, that you're hoping for one answer, and when you get the wrong answer, you're scared to ask the next question.
Yeah.
So
am I the person
to
ask? No.
That's not.
What did Jackie say?
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
You know exactly what I said. It's like talking to your father at the party.
Yeah. Right.
Like, yeah.
You know what it's like.
And you ask a girl, and then she tells you something, and you don't want to know.
And then, you know, you ask one thing, yeah. And then she says the other thing, and it wasn't the thing that you asked.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, great.
All right, man, I got to go.
If I put on a Sergeant Pepper jacket, can I have sex with you?
No, it won't make it.
Hey, you know I love you, don't you?
Me when you call me a gook.
Oh.
Come here,
you little gook. Come here, you firm little gook. I want you now. I want your buttocks. I want your firm young buttocks. Give me a firm young buttocks. And Asian Kloogie.
And Gilbert doesn't understand why he doesn't get women.
Well, he tries to be nice for 2 seconds. It doesn't work. They're repulsed by him. Then he starts calling them nips and gooks.
It's like having sex with each of the three-headed monster. Oh.
Zelda was staring at him like the same thing. Couldn't believe that was going on at the same time.
Who was staring at him?
Belzer.
Oh, Belzer. Oh, Belzer was there for that?
Oh, yeah. Well, Belzer is like...
Was Belzer freaking out?
Yeah.
He couldn't believe it.
You're insulting, like, another race, you know, like... You're taking in a whole community. And you know,
Gilbert, you're a Jew. And, yes. You know, Jews
you
were...
You should know better because of the persecution. You should inherently know the persecution.
Remember the pogrom.
Yes.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Oh, there's someone from Playboy here. I'm getting away because, you know, they abuse women.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I can't talk to anyone here but you.
Yeah.
All right.
There's no one here I can talk to.
By the way, May Pang has, her book is your book still available?
No, in fact, I'm doing a book of photographs. They can get the book.
Of John?
Of John's penis.
No. She's working on those photographs.
I'm working on other stuff.
She's as bad as Yoko. She'll find stuff of John, and she'll find more stuff about
John. She's still mining the John memorabilia.
The left side of me penis is more photogenic.
You know what you ought to call it?
What?
Pang alive.
I can follow Robin in that respect. It'd be great.
No, May, you're working on a book of what? Photographs of what?
Give me a pang.
From a lot of the Apple era of old different people that were, from the Apple days. Because a lot of people have written in. They wanted to know what it was like, who was around in those days. All the, you know, like the Badfinger, Jackie Lomax.
Oh, let me give you some Badfinger.
Oh, yeah.
Try out me Badfinger.
They come back to life.
You're not built like other girls. You look like a fortune cookie down there. You'll need the Badfinger.
Oh,
tell me me fortune.
Let me see if I can get me fortune.
Oh, my. Oh, do you like me Badfinger? Could I please touch your pang? I want your pang. Let me touch your pang.
Let me pang you.
Let me pang you. Let me pang you all day. May I pang you.
All right, May.
All right.
Bye, May.
You know we love you.
See ya.
Do you know we love you?
I know you do.
I know. I don't like what Gilbert says.
Yeah. It's really, like, wrong.
All right.
I'll check you later.
Good boy, May. I want it now.
That's May Pang, of course, who is so a part of them. All right. We'll be back with Gilbert Gottfried in the news. We're going to explore a couple of things that are going on. Gilbert has many things. He has many critical thoughts.
Yes. Many important thoughts.
I want to start a TV channel, show the OJ trial, and have me and Gilbert there.
Gilbert doing commentary.
Yeah, Gilbert doing commentary. We'll be back right after this.
And let's do some news.
Gilbert, if you have some commentary, feel free to chime in.
Okay. Bang, bang.
Well, you know, ever since I did that story the other day about the young man who electrocuted himself with the cow's heart.
Did you hear about this?
No.
There's a guy. Let me get him up to date.
Phil Gilberton.
All right. This kid, his parents, the cops or something, found him dead. Well, at first they thought, they didn't know what the hell it was.
They thought it was a satanic ritual.
Because they found this cow's heart. But he'd been reading some magazine where they say if you get a battery and two wires and you hook a cow's heart into a certain way, you can get the cow heart to feel like a woman's private parts. So the kid was like experimenting.
Did he write it down how to do it?
But instead of putting the battery, he plugged this thing into the wall, these wires, and electrocuted himself. Gilbert's taking notes.
No reason to shelve the whole idea.
Right. Go back to the drawing board.
So the safe way is with a battery.
Yeah.
Okay.
I told that Playboy Playmate of the Year yesterday, I said, if you ever die, just cut out your private parts, and I'll hook them up to my battery. So anyway, what happened since...
Send Gary down to get me a cow's heart.
Well, now what you have a problem with is this internet.
Yes.
And the kind of information people are putting on it.
What did they do?
Well, of course, all this information that kids and other people are using to make bombs, you can find that on the internet.
Right.
You can also find these crazy sexual things on the internet, too, I guess.
Fantastic!
Well, what can I do? I would try the cow's heart.
Today somebody sent me something that you use...
Now, how do you actually do the cow's heart?
...amplifier for?
That's nothing to cow's heart. You know what I did the other day?
Yeah.
Somebody gave me... Robin, he doesn't even know this.
Oh. Yeah, it's true.
So somebody gives me a rubber... woman's private parts.
Uh-huh.
It's molded from Savannah, the porn star who died.
Very
well, I know it could have been a real private part. They were like rubber.
Yes.
I took it home. I waited for my kids, my wife, everyone, the housekeepers out of the house. And I start using this thing because I figured, let me try it. And I didn't know you were supposed to use KY jelly. I was bruised. I was black and blue. And mutilated. You ever do that?
Stuff seems to be...
No, I've seen them. I've never tried one. Well,
yeah, I'm sure. Yeah,
where
sure.
Have you been shot?
Right.
I've been scared to.
See, you saw that at the supermarket.
Not that I didn't want to. I've just been scared to.
It kind of works.
Yeah.
But not good enough.
Okay, but what does it feel like? Does it just vibrate?
No vibration.
It
pulls.
It pulls?
Yeah.
It sucks. Then I'll have to try one.
Yeah. Try it, but you just buy a big tube of jelly.
Yeah.
It has a suction thing.
I use lubricant.
How does it suck? How does it...
No, it's just like when you... It's like a
vacuum thing. It's so small that it grabs you.
Oh, okay.
Go ahead. I can't be any more graphic than that.
There you go. Well, this one...
This is embarrassing.
So it actually bruised you?
And I was naked and I was standing in front of my mirror with this thing. And like I'm looking
And if that didn't disgust you...
Yeah, and I caught myself in the mirror. I looked at myself and go, look at you. You're 41 years old. You got three kids.
You can't stand by the mirror.
And you're with a piece of rubber. So then I went and laid down on my bed. And I had my legs up in the air.
Well, listen to this. This one comes with a warning. If you are electronically illiterate, if you've never handled a wire sugar and a soldering iron.
Soldering iron.
Or a soldering iron. What do I know? I've never done this.
A soldering iron?
Yeah.
Never handled a soldering iron.
Thank you, Gilbert.
Then you would be dilapidated to multiply the specifications.
All right, let her read the rest of this.
Do not attempt to perform this experiment.
If you don't have a soldering iron...
No, if you've never used one.
Right.
They're telling you, if you don't understand electricity...
Don't do it.
These kinds
don't
of things...
Don't try these tricks at home.
Do not do this.
So you have to be an electronics major to do
this. Right. You need an audio amplifier with 1 to 5 watts per channel.
Sounds good.
I'm getting turned on.
Battery-powered is best for safety reasons. Although they have used plug-in amplifiers... for several years with only one unpleasant accident.
What was the unpleasant accident?
I don't know.
I don't know, man, but solder and sex should not be in the same sentence. I mean, you need to start soldering to get laid. I say you're in big trouble.
Do not use an expensive high-powered amplifier. They can be damaged by short circuits.
You'll kill yourself. You'll kill yourself.
Yes.
And by being connected to loads of unusual impedance.
I have an impedance. I got a peen in my impedance.
You need a tone generator.
It's a tone impedance.
And some kind of 18-gauge copper wire. Yeah.
That's wild.
That's wild.
Maybe some connectors, the soldering iron, and wire, and a wire stripper. So somehow or other, you connect this all together, and then you set the amplifier's volume control to minimum.
That is clever. Clever
set
stuff.
Set your tone source to produce a continuous tone of 440 hertz.
Evacuating.
Insert a small loop electrode just inside
I'm going to insert my small loop electrode.
Inside your urethra.
And get out of here.
Urethra?
I wouldn't do that.
And then you can
say, I don't even know I have that. I thought girls had that.
Going on here.
Oh, you cock of a lip.
And then you insert the big loop electrode.
I can't hear anything.
Just inside another part of your anatomy.
You can't hear anything because you're talking so much.
I just knocked over this.
Oh, good.
Okay, great.
Pour water over electronics.
Yeah. So now that you're all hooked up.
That's why I electrocuted myself the first time. No, you actually have to insert this.
And
yeah, that's what
place,
she said.
One electrode one place and one electrode the other.
Well, that's sick. And let me say something.
And then you slowly turn the volume up on the amplifier.
I am not doing that. And I don't recommend that to anybody at
home. They say experiment with different frequencies and waveforms.
Oh, for God's sake. Oh, stop this already. What is
if
that?
You produce
all right.
Some stimulation you like.
Oh, cut that out.
They say.
I can't take it.
You're an animal. Oh, my goodness.
You can actually even.
Oh, you crazy kid.
They say there's a face.
You're disgusting.
Stop it.
Kids, what's the matter with kids today?
Why can't they be like we were?
Different in every way.
What's the matter with kids today?
They say there's a phase two, if you like it.
Oh, there's a wire in my penis. Oh, my goodness.
So that's some of the wacky stuff you can find with this new computer technology we have.
Does it come with batteries? Oh, my goodness.
You must have really dug it when Charlie Weaver was sitting directly under you.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, let's take a break. We'll do some more news when we get back. I'm here with my cow's heart.
Oh, baby.
I got a cow's heart, Robin. I just got a hold of it. I'm naked. I have my cow's heart. And it's got two new batteries. Wait a second. I need more juice. I'm going to plug this into the wall. Hold on a second. Imagine my parents find me. If your parents got a call that they found you naked next to a cow's heart plugged into the wall.
Next to it? It was still attached.
Yeah?
It was still attached.
Here's $10,000. You didn't find anybody, okay?
Yeah, right. Let's keep this out of newspapers. We're going to bury him in the backyard. Yeah. No funeral.
We didn't have a son.
Yeah. What son? Oh, that was the doorman. Yeah.
Right, yeah. Man, that's a hell of a thing. I used to do weird stuff when my parents would go out of the house. So I got naked, and I remember I went on their bed to watch Gilligan's Island because I was waiting for Ginger. And I had never actually done it to myself. My friends had told me about it. I was just a kid.
So you were going to experiment.
Yeah, and I literally did number one all over their bed.
Oh.
Yeah. I had to change the sheets and everything. Oh, man. Well, I actually got mostly on my stomach, so.
How old were you?
14, 15. No, no. I was, I must have been about 10 or 11.
Why did you do that?
I didn't know what to do. They said that it was supposed to feel good, and I was waiting for something to happen. And
electrical wires.
Yeah, but I mean, the cops didn't find me laying in my bed.
Good thing the internet didn't exist at that time.
Oh, I needed the internet. I would have been hooked up to all kinds of wires. I would have looked like Frankenstein's monster. I would have had everything. It would have been hearts. Plugged into the wall.
Yeah, well, that's hot. Good.
Oh, man.
House hot. Friend.
Fresh. Why don't you go dress up as Frankenstein and go downstairs and interview black people?
Frankenstein, Godfrey.
Oh, Jay, guilty.
Well, there is now another suspect in the Oklahoma bombing. Investigators are...
Who's the suspect?
Jackie Mom.
Terry Nichols, the guy who was just an accessory the other day, is now a full-fledged suspect. He was charged yesterday in the bombing and faces a preliminary hearing in Oklahoma today.
Yeah, Gilbert's thinking of joining a militia. He wants to be a general.
That's right. He's angry about Waco.
He thinks he can get girls.
Yes.
And he's angry about Waco. Imagine being that. I mean, like, I watched it on TV. It had no effect on me, Waco. I was glad they were all gone. I didn't care that they were dead. I didn't care about anything. Some guys actually got pissed off.
Yeah.
I mean, enough to blow up a building.
These were a bunch of nuts.
Yeah.
Building, like, you really care.
I mean, I'm watching them go, are there going to be any pictures of good-looking girls or what? I mean, that's it.
It's like the Manson family.
I know.
Blew them up.
Yeah. And it always amazes me when I read months later that a guy was so pissed off about Waco. And I start to examine myself. I go, man, am I shallow?
Didn't affect you.
Like, I sat in front of the TV. I watched Waco. And, like, I didn't even, like, talk about it with my parents. I didn't talk to my wife about it.
Like, Janet Reno's terrible because she blew him up.
Yeah. A bunch of police officers go over, they knock on the door and say, excuse me, we have a search warrant. They kill all the police officers. There was no issue in my mind. Blow up the building.
Yeah.
Get rid of Waco.
One religious freak and a bunch of idiots.
They killed their own children. It wasn't like we did it.
Yeah.
I feel more when I step on ants.
I know.
And then all of a sudden, there's some guy out there, Terry Nichols or something. He's sitting there, he's like, I gotta blow up a building. I'm pissed. You're kidding me.
That wasn't right.
But, you mean, what's wrong with me?
I felt worse when Archie Bunker's place went off the air.
Right.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Fantastic. They killed everyone in Waco. It was fantastic.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Waco is so close to Waco, it's not even funny.
The Dallas Morning News is citing unidentified sources that say Nichols has admitted driving the truck from Kansas to Oklahoma City that the bomb was delivered in.
Who even knew that?
He told officials he didn't know what the truck would be used for.
Who even knew that cow duty could blow up buildings? That's what was in the truck.
Well, did you see
cows are good for everything.
Johnny Cochran is now suing the company that made the fertilizer?
Why?
Claiming that they didn't put something in it that could have made it less volatile. Yeah, or possibly could have prevented it from being explosive at all.
Johnny Cochran's concern for people is so heartwarming. I got to tell you, and the way he just marries women or takes up with them, I don't know. And
it has nothing to
hello,
do.
Hello, this is Johnny Cochran here.
For the fertilizer.
I'm here to talk about that cow doo-doo. Now, the cow heart, that's a good thing. But the cow doo-doo, we got to put a log in.
No wonder like the Chinese worship cows, man. They make bombs, they got sex with the hearts.
They are potent.
Dude, the Indians won't even eat them.
They're very potent, too.
Do you know that the Indians are starving and they won't eat a cow? Now I know why. We can't eat it. We can blow up buildings and have sex with his heart.
That's our secret weapon.
Give me another battery.
Yeah, secret weapon. You make love to it, then you blow it up.
Last night
but don't
on
eat it.
Primetime, Diane Sawyer interviewed the 12-year-old son of Terry Nichols. I told you the other day there were reports that the boy had been at the home of his father a few days before the bombing, and the two of them had discussed explosives, and it actually his father had taught him how to blow up some things. So here is the little boy. Play it in reverse order.
Ooh.
I bet he pull.
You want number three first?
Yes.
Okay.
Here is the son of Terry Nichols.
My dad started doing gun shows and making...
Speak clearly.
You saw him do that. Mm-hmm. But did you know what they were for? No, we were just in Kansas. We're just making them and throwing them. He showed me how to make some.
12-year-olds, I hate talking to 12-year-olds. They can't articulate. They think they're speaking so freaking clearly. You see, my daughter's friend. All my daughter's friends are 12 years old. Yeah. She's 12 years old. They all call on the answering machine. They're like, this is the message you hear.
Hey, this is the one who's calling me.
I just ignore it. I don't even tell her there's a phone call for her. It can't be important. I just don't even pay attention. Screw
you
that.
Know who it is?
No. It's like, and my wife can interpret this, and the kids all understand it. They go, oh, it's Taylor. And it's like, you know,
Hi, this is Jamie.
I go, who's that? Jamie. Oh, okay. Whatever. I don't know.
And here is the son's response to the question, did he know what his father was up to?
I just thought
does he think his father is involved?
I just thought Dad was going to help me put some explosive in the basketballs at school, so that's a trick. All right, here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sounds like Gilbert on a date. What did you say?
I don't want to sleep with you.
I don't want to put your kluge.
I touch your kluge.
No, I don't think you do.
So he doesn't think he's
good interview.
Involved. And here is Lana Padilla, who is the ex-wife.
Are you Lana Padilla?
Nichols.
Do you have a sister? What's her name?
Sue.
Her name is Sue.
That was a pretty good interview with that 12-year-old, though. I learned a lot. You know they should have had to do the interview? Johnny Carson. He was good interviewing kids.
So did you make a bomb?
Yeah.
So, your father blew up a building. Yeah. Oh, that's clever stuff. Wow, that's wild. That's wild.
All right, here's Laura Padilla.
Lana, isn't it?
Yeah. Laura.
It is?
Is your name Lana? Or is it Laura? So they're both right.
A breaking a person with.
I like a woman who has music behind her when she talks.
Here's how you go around in life.
Yeah, I have an actual guy I hired to make a soundtrack.
But we really didn't know anything, and we Josh and I don't know anything.
Husband just ruined their lives.
Yes. You gotta wonder about a guy who takes his son out in the backyard, teaches him to build explosives, and throws. It's a terrible thing.
He could have put a little explosion in our love making. What else is in the news, Robin?
Robin Cotton, the doctor.
I've been robbing some cotton.
Yeah.
I don't like to buy the cotton, so I just start robbing cotton.
And the biochemist who is testifying in the O.J. Simpson trial.
I had a chemist friend.
Will you be
and
quiet?
When I was leaving him, I said, biochemist.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, come on, let us finish.
The DNA lesson, you know, teaching these jurors and the rest of the court about reading DNA evidence, and now she is giving the evidence. So yesterday they revealed whose blood it was that they found on this bloody glove.
I wonder whose blood it was.
On the O.J. Simpson property.
It could be a surprise.
They said O.J. had no reaction.
So he put his D in her A?
Oh, shit.
Looked like President Clinton's blood.
She testified that a drop of blood found at the crime scene contained Simpson's genetic fingerprint.
Look out!
But I didn't leave no fingerprint.
I was wearing a glove at the time.
She also told jurors that the DNA from a bloody sock found at Simpson's home is consistent with Nicole Brown Simpson's blood.
I object. I just want to say, as O.J. Simpson, I wasn't wearing socks that night.
Simpson's defense says the DNA results are meaningless because the evidence was tainted by police or was planted by them, one or the other.
Wham, the mistrial I've been hearing so much about. Mistrial, she's cute.
Hello there, mistrial. Couldn't I put my DNA?
So that's continuing today in the O.J. Simpson case. I also understand that two more jurors are under investigation.
Really?
Yeah, so we may see some more jurors expelled.
Put me on the jury. I've watched the whole damn case on TV. I'm ready to move the verdict. What genre of people would be...
I don't know what genre they're coming in these days.
What genre of...
Could you give us a hint what types of people these are?
One of them is an alternate juror who just replaced the woman who left a couple of weeks ago, the stewardess who left.
They're going to replace the alternate?
Yeah.
What genre?
I don't know. But they said the two may have made statements as to the fact that they think O.J. Simpson is guilty.
Well, who doesn't?
Oh, he.
They're not supposed to make those statements, though. Remember the admonitions of the judge every day at the end of a court session?
Who can take him seriously?
Oh, very clever.
Don't talk about case. Well, what are we supposed to talk about?
Jesus.
We're locked in a room for 24 hours. The only thing we know about is the case. What are we going to do? It's like me and Gilbert staring at each other at Robin's party.
Gotta talk about something.
Yeah.
Talk about cowhawk.
Very good.
Oh,
me like him very much.
Don't break at the wall.
President Clinton has left Russia and is on his way to Kiev. Where he's met with the president of the Ukraine.
Now, are you in Kiev? How do you have a lawyer?
Oh, shut up already. Right.
A day and a half, but before he left Russia, President Clinton termed his talks with Boris Yeltsin yesterday very constructive.
Oh, he did?
Yes.
Let's hear that. I didn't realize.
I would love to. I came on this trip because first I wanted to express the feelings of the United States on the 50th anniversary of the end of World War II, and to finally acknowledge the enormous sacrifice of the Russian people. And secondly, because I am trying to increase the security of the people of America and the people of Russia.
So he feels that he accomplished both missions. Last night I turned on the TV to get a little entertainment, and all I could find was the Country Music Award.
And Gilbert on Conan.
So, for the first time in a long time, they say, a woman was named Country Music Entertainer of the Year, and that woman is...
Wee Dougie!
Reba McEntire. Here she is.
Are you familiar with any of her songs?
Oh, she's great. I
love
her.
Here she
music.
Is performing, play number 7 first.
Okay. Good.
The winner of the Country Music Performer of the Year.
Well, if she's the performer of the year, she must be fantastic. Let's listen. Reefer McEntire. All right. That's enough of that. That's really good.
Oh, it's so different. Oh, yeah.
I take it back. I like Latin music.
Do you like rap music?
Wow.
And here she is making her acceptance speech as she was named Entertainer of the Year.
This is not of entertainment, but I have
Uber.
To say, from the bottom of my heart, being an Okie, born and raised.
Yeah, that's something to be proud of.
I'm going to dedicate this to all the folks who are left behind.
Like who?
The co-workers, the family, the friends. Our heart goes out for you. And we love you.
Oh, boy.
So she dedicated that to the people of Oklahoma.
No, that didn't sound like Oklahoma. It sounded like the people on her road crew.
Yeah.
The people left behind.
She's an Okie.
No. I was going to say she should have done for the people. What the hell do with Oklahoma? It should have been.
Play it again.
She's talking about her road crew.
No, she's not.
All the men and all the women who stay at home waiting for their men to come back from their tours.
No.
Of course.
That's.
Oh, come on, play it again. I don't think so. I thought she was talking about Oklahoma. She's
nothing about Oklahoma.
Woman, you care less.
Play it.
This is not of entertainment, but I have to say, from the bottom of my heart, being an Okie.
Bottom of my cow heart.
I'm going to dedicate this to all the folks who are left behind. The co-workers, the family, the friends. Our heart goes out for you.
See, you're talking about people in that
and
building.
We love you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's her crew.
Hate to agree with Robin, but she's right.
I think Robin's right now that I hear it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I almost had you convinced, though. She was talking about us.
Well, it was an eloquent speech.
I was going to say, why doesn't she dedicate it to the people of Oklahoma?
Yeah.
Why is it, though, that the people in England can sing without an accent, but these people can't?
They don't want
to. The heart is a lonely hunter.
That's pretty good. All right, why don't we... you got any more news?
I have a couple more stories.
All right, let me take a break.
Break. Yeah. Come back, finish up.
Gilbert, during the commercials, can I eat in front of you, or are you going to start demanding all kinds of food?
Yes, I'll start demanding.
All right, good. All right, we'll be back right after this. Nothing more upsetting than eating in front of Gilbert Gottfried.
Does he stare at you?
Yeah, he stares, and every bite he's taking with me. Caroline's in New York on May 25th is lucky enough to have Gilbert Gottfried there, where he lights the room on fire.
Yes.
One or two shows?
I think one.
One.
Might be two. I don't know.
Well, you really...
I never know.
Your career's really taking off. You've been doing the same thing for 20 years.
Yes.
All right, this Saturday, 8 p.m. on NBC, Problem Child 3, you star in that.
Yes, fine script.
You're out of, everyone else has abandoned Problem
fine
Child.
Script?
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
What was it about the script that attracted you to the project?
I felt it was much deeper with the character.
You did?
Yeah.
You wouldn't have done it had the character not grown, right?
No, and it's much different than the character I was on Wings.
Right.
This was more introspective.
Really?
Yes.
So because of the depth of the script, you went into this.
Yes.
You don't believe
in
sequels.
I saw the script, right. I just fell in love.
Right. So Problem Child will be on Saturday, 8 p.m. And USA Up All Night every Saturday night. It's Gilbert Gottfried, and Caroline's on May 25th.
Always Gilbert.
All Gilbert all the time.
Yeah.
He's their biggest star. Good for you, Gilbert. Things going really well. I understood you played a parrot recently.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I did.
Unbelievable.
Return of Jafar, available on tapes.
Good for you.
Ah.
Things going well.
Yes.
No, things are going real well.
Fire your rig.
Yeah. Okay.
So, Robin, you said you had a few more stories.
Yes, Tupac Shakur is attempting to appeal his conviction on sexual abuse charges. And the judge yesterday set bail at $1.4 million.
Where am I going to get that?
The bail?
I never even met May Pang.
Until...
That Japanese bro don't know what she's talking about.
As his appeal is settled.
Somehow Gilbert put May Pang and Tupac Shakur together.
I don't know how he did that. Yeah.
All you need is love.
Will you be doing that at Caroline's, putting those together?
Yes.
Okay.
Can't wait to see that.
Gilbert looked at my lunch and he goes, what's that?
Yeah.
Is that good?
I had to order something he didn't want.
Yes.
A Hollis man was badly burned on Easter Sunday when a burst of steam and hot water exploded from the shower head in his apartment.
Can that happen? Your shower head can explode?
It says it here.
He
just won a $1.4 million settlement in Queens Civil Court from the building's landlord.
I never get anything.
Yeah.
My shower head exploded. I didn't have nobody to see.
Isn't that terrible? That's awful, but... gotten $1.4 million.
Is it really the landlord's fault, though, Robin? I mean, what?
They're responsible for the heat and hot water in the building, don't you think?
Yeah, but I mean, like, so you buy
and maintaining the pipes and the equipment.
Yeah, okay, but let me ask you something.
What?
You buy a shower head, right?
Yes.
And maybe the manufacturer didn't make it so good or whatever. Or maybe the shower head, you know, I don't know. So you put it in there, and let's say you put it in, you know, good faith. And the
maybe
thing explodes.
Maybe you didn't. You're assuming it's good faith.
I guess. I don't know all the facts of the case. I don't know. But some of these cases, I don't know. It seems like, you know, everybody's got to know everything.
An investigation revealed a defective mixing valve in the hot water distribution system.
It happens. How am I supposed to be on top of that?
So maybe he knew it all along.
See, OJ, you should have put Nicole in the shower. With an exploding device.
Well, it didn't.
I should have given her a cow's heart.
Yeah.
I would love to.
Who has the longest
Not
sperm?
Me.
Not you.
Yeah. I have the shortest sperm.
Yes.
No, you have human sperm, and I'm sure, regardless of the equipment that you use to deliver it, it's the same size as most.
I don't know about that. What animal has the shortest sperm?
What living, what life form, let's say?
Gilbert Gottfried.
I would say... The ape.
No.
I know. I would say, I'm gonna guess the amoeba.
The amoeba doesn't even have sperm.
Huh? Oh.
That makes the two of us.
Then it's short.
The longest sperm.
The elephant.
Is produced.
The giraffe.
By.
It's got the longest neck.
A tiny fruit fly.
Really?
Yes. It produces
sperm. I did not
sperm.
Know that. That is wild. Oh.
I have the tastiest.
Drosophila bisecta.
I second that.
The Drosophila bifurca produces a sperm 2.3 inches long.
Minutia.
Yeah.
Can you imagine that? You could see that with the naked eye, 2.3 inches long.
That's me.
It's about 20 times as long as the fly itself.
I did not know that.
That is wild.
It is wild.
Very wild.
Weird.
The sperm is 1,000 times as long as human sperm.
Yeah.
Oh, how is your sperm, Ed?
Remember when Gilbert is always so good on our show that ABC, the program director from ABC Radio heard him on, and they said, oh, we better give him a show.
Uh-huh.
So Gilbert went on and did his own show. What a nightmare that was.
Oh, yes.
Huh? I heard that show. I heard it for about 15 minutes.
Gilbert, did you enjoy doing that?
Did you enjoy it?
Oh, yes.
You're looking to get into radio?
Oh, yes. It was always my dream in life to be Cousin Brucey.
Gilbert was yelling at people.
I wanted to be Dandy Dan.
Dandy Dan Godfrey.
Yes.
Wow. Heidi Fleiss's father has pleaded guilty to conspiracy charges under an agreement with federal prosecutors. He was accused of helping to launder hundreds of thousands of dollars from his daughter's prostitution ring.
What a dad. I can't understand something. He was a medical doctor. Probably had a lot of money. But he
I
just got into...
So, but it says here that he's agreed to some deal with prosecutors to plead guilty to conspiracy charges to launder this money.
Very unfortunate.
Facing a maximum of 10 months
very
in jail.
Sad.
Now, that's
his
a sad
daughter
story.
Is scheduled for a hearing.
No, I can't joke about that.
Yeah, I'm not going to make any jokes about that.
A sentencing hearing tomorrow.
That's a guy, you know, he's a father. It's not funny.
It's just wrong.
Right.
It's just wrong. Long-term
story.
Go to the next story. That's
certain stories we can't make jokes about.
You often wonder if a girl in this line of work has the consent of a parent.
Okay, enough.
All right.
Robert, don't make
I'm
the
not
situation.
I'm not going to draw you two in.
There's a lot of people suffering around that Heidi Fleiss trial.
Person has some...
A right to privacy.
Yeah.
Right.
Let's just stop it.
Now,
right.
This is
terrible.
A New York City man on trial for murder slashed his own throat with a razor blade while he was on the witness stand yesterday. I guess testimony wasn't going well. Robert Skinner had just begun a statement about his January 1994 shooting of a Utica man when he dismantled a disposable razor and cut himself in front of the jury. Trying to get sympathy, I suppose.
Utica.
Ugh.
Tough town.
Crazy town. To a psychiatric unit for observation.
No, this was
after
in the paper. This
being
was in the paper.
Treated at the hospital.
Is it an actual article from the paper?
No, I swear.
It was
swear.
In the paper.
This was,
true story?
Yes, this is true story.
I'm so glad he retired. Flaming jackass, liver-spotted jerk.
David Hinckley is the columnist, the radio columnist from the Daily News, is really in war with us.
I know he is. He's a weird guy. And you know what I decided about him?
What?
No one reads his column.
Except us.
Let's stop talking about it. And you want to know something else? His columns don't make sense. Every time I even try to understand them, I mean, the guy's a lousy writer. They don't make sense. I don't care what anyone... That's why he never got off the radio column. I know he's in a war. He's got some agenda, but the guy can't even write, so why would he be insulted by it?
I don't even understand what we did to him to get him so upset.
He's a jackass. I met him. He's a wimp in real life. He didn't have the balls to ask me one question. Just goes back to his little typewriter and writes.
And then he has all of his opinions.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, that's all I have to say today.
Thank you, Robin. My darling Robin today will be out at a book signing.
She's good.
She's real good, OJ. And, she will be signing. Now, you are signing the first edition is still available in the stores, right?
That's the valuable one. Yeah.
That's the one they should all run out and buy. Any fans of the show will want to know the inside scoop, the poop on Robin.
Poopy.
Yeah.
Now, that is a wild story, Robin.
Yes, it is a wild story.
So you're going to be at... Let me just tell you the places you're going to be at. You're going to be at...
Walden
I got it.
Walden Books in Wall Street.
Walden Books on Wall Street at 12:30 and at Crown Books in DuPont Circle in Washington, D.C., Saturday, May 13th. And she will sign copies of her book, the bestseller, Quivers, A Life. And you'll learn many things that even I didn't know.
You'll learn something about yourself.
OJ, would you like to learn some new things?
I would love to.
Okay. Our good friend Gilbert Gottfried... Our dear, sweet friend, Gilbert Gottfried.
Fantastic!
He will, of course, you can see him Saturday night, 8 p.m. on NBC Problem Trial 3. For those of you lucky enough to get into Caroline's in New York on May 25th, God bless you. You will learn stuff about Gilbert that I didn't even know.
Fantastic!
USA Up All Night every Saturday night. Don't miss it because the production values alone are worth watching.
Unbelievable!
Jackie, Jokeman, Martling, you're doing great. Go to Jackie's CD, Martling, Alive. The Wild Comedy CD, or cassette, Robin.
Mm-hmm. He should have been there.
$10 plus $3 shipping and handling. Jokeland special. Buy two, get one free. Call 1-800-323-KING. Jackie will, of course, be there Saturday, May 13th at Headliners Comedy Club in Bethesda, Maryland. All of Washington talking about that. Simultaneously, Robin, you will be signing books in the afternoon. You will be there the same day. It's an invasion. With Jackie at night and you
right,
in the afternoon.
That's right. We're taking over.
For Filthy Jokes and Robin X Church, call 516-9221. Remember, 516-9221 is not a pay service. Tonight and tonight only. Fred Norris Band at Brews on 34th Street between 3rd and Lex. And Oh Miss Boy Gary this Saturday from noon to 2 p.m. representing Prodigy at Software Etc. on 83rd and Broadway in Manhattan, giving away free Prodigy software.
It's great.
To order a signed copy of Stuttering John CD, call 201-942. Ouch. Hey, Jackie's wife is a big yenta, and she'll be with her band all folked up. Nancy Sirianni Martling, all folked up. Big showcase tonight.
To my wife, Nancy, for Jessica Hahn, Beth. I've been stupid, and I'll never do anything like that again, and I love you, and I'm very sorry. And I'm very sincere. And
you're a Martian, Norris.
At 8 p.m., that's at 55 Grove Street in Greenwich Village, Nancy Sirianni. Jimmy Brawless. If you're planning a wedding or party, you need a DJ. Why don't you call Smokey the Engineer, Scott, at Rocket Entertainment?
I think I'll, excuse me for a minute, I am entitled to 3 cigarette breaks during your party. What I'm going to do now is put on a hokey pokey and take a cigarette break.
Called a hokey smokey hokey pokey.
Do you really think he negotiates that, his break?
Absolutely. If you want a celebrity like myself, I'll need to smoke and unwind.
Read the writer. It's right there.
What's the matter? Don't you read your writer?
Call 718-BAG-5040 for Scott the Engineer. He'll imagine a celebrity like Scott at your party.
Oh, yes.
Great.
It's fantastic.
And Gilbert, thanks, and we'll see you at Caroline's on May 25th.
You should have been there.
And we'll see you all tomorrow. Robin, good luck at your book signing today. I know that the first edition is the one to get signed. That's what I'm going for.
Everybody should want that. Yep. You should have that in your collection.
You understand that, Gilbert. In the book collecting world, if you can get a first edition, if you buy the first edition, it's even more valuable.
Have you ever seen those ads later on? People are saying, well, I have a first edition copy.
You can still get first edition in the store, but they're going quick, obviously. It's a bestseller.
Unbelievable.
Right. All right. See you tomorrow.